The Voice of America presents Jazz Club USA. The Voice of America presents another in the series of programs designed to bring you jazz at its best. And here is your commentator, the well-known jazz critic and composer, Leonard Feather.
Greetings and modulations. Later on today, our Jazz Club microphone will be taking us to a Hollywood jam session and a personal interview with a great musician. But for the first half of today's show, our scene is a radio studio in New York, where there was a weekly program recently called Saturday Night Review. One of the items in this show every week was a number by the Johnny Smith Quintet, and we've taken some of the best things they did on several Saturday nights and recorded these broadcasts for you to hear now. Let's hear them first in Cherokee. By now, I imagine you're curious about the Johnny Smith Quintet's personnel. Well, Johnny himself is a guitarist who played with the Benny Goodman Sextet in 1950, but he works mostly in the radio studios now. For today's performances, he has with him, on tenor sax and clarinet, the most popular young sax man in modern jazz today, Stan Getz. And the rest of the group comprises Joseph Kahn at the piano, Bunny Shocker on drums, and Dave Walter on bass. Next, they're going to do a very interesting arrangement of Taboo, followed by Where or When. Thank you. Johnny Smith is not only a fine guitarist, he writes some very attractive original pieces for his group, and you're going to hear one of them next. Here's the quintet in Speaking for Myself. That's a very fitting title for a jazz piece, Speaking for Myself, because that's just what jazz musicians do. There is no thought control over what they say. I guess it's the freedom of expression they enjoy that makes jazz so obnoxious to all forms of totalitarian government. I imagine some of you still remember how the Nazis frowned on jazz, how they banned a lot of artists and composers from public performance in Germany. And today, in Eastern Germany and in a number of other countries, exactly the same thing is happening under the communists. Like all dictatorships, they resent jazz, just as the Nazis did, because they know this is the music where people can be found speaking for themselves. And now it's time for Johnny Smith to speak for himself again, aided by Stan Getz in the rhythm section, in a final number before we meet our special guest. It's Johnny's new treatment of the old favorite, Sometimes I'm Happy. Now it's my great pleasure to introduce a man who has been a very important figure in jazz for a number of years and whom I have known as a friend and admired in quite a few countries, as a matter of fact. I would say since the golden era of swing through the modern age, and he is still one of the outstanding figures, not only as an instrumentalist, but as a composer and arranger, Benny Carter.
Thank you, Leonard, and hello, music lovers all over the world.
All over the world is probably almost not much more than your own territory, Benny, because I know you've traveled far and wide in your quest for audiences, and you've found very receptive ones in quite a number of countries.
Well, but I have been very fortunate.
Well, as a matter of fact, I remember being with you in the Netherlands when you made some very successful records there.
Yes.
That was quite a few years ago, and I remember that for the past few years, you've been mostly out in California and have been spending very little time in New York. Is there any special reason for that?
Well, I've been fairly regularly employed in the film studios doing a little writing for pictures. And
can you name some of the pictures that you've been connected with during the years?
Oh, yes, I guess it starts with a picture called Stormy Weather, which I did some years ago.
I remember that well.
And coming through, Wintertime, and that's a Sonia Haney picture.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's see, recently, Panic in the Streets, My Blue Heaven. And this year, The Snows of Kilimanjaro.
Oh.
A Night Without Sleep.
Yeah, it's pretty rough to catch up on all these pictures. I haven't seen a couple of those myself. I didn't even realize that you contributed to them. And I know on some of them you wrote music, original background music, scores, and on others you played alto sax as well, and on still others I believe you played trumpet, didn't you?
That's right.
I
and
still
in a couple
don't...
of a couple of them, you see my face for just a fleeting moment.
Yes.
And American in Paris, for instance.
Oh, that's right. I do remember that scene in American in Paris. Well, Benny, you play so many instruments so well that, of course, you're principally known as an alto saxophonist, but I just wonder whether you've ever decided which is your preference, your personal preference for the one you like to play.
Oh, I don't know. I don't think that matters a great deal. As a matter of fact, though, I do like playing the trumpet, but it seems that I'm expected to make with the alto when I put in a personal appearance.
Well, the reason for that, of course, is that you've made so many fans all over the world for so many years playing alto saxophone that people expect to hear that first, and then it just comes as an extra added attraction when you surprise them with a wonderful trumpet solo. So whatever it is you're doing, I know that you're always eminently successful at it, and I'd like to turn you over to that occupation right now and thank you for joining us momentarily here on Jazz Club USA.
Well, it's certainly been a pleasure, Leonard. Thank you very much.
Here's Errol Garner at the piano introducing some 1 o'clock jump music at one of the famous Just Jazz concerts presented by Gene Norman in Hollywood, California. And Benny Carter will be joining the group in a few minutes. Thank you. tenor saxophonist is the former Benny Goodman and Count Basie star, Wardell Gray. McGhee on trumpet. Trombone stylist whom we met on a Dixieland session recently, Vic Dickenson. Here comes our guest, playing as eloquently as he just spoke, Benny Carter on alto sax. Thank you. King Cole guitar soloist, Irving Ashby. Rhythm section on that concert was composed of Jackie Mills on drums, Red Callender on bass, plus Irving Ashby and Erroll Garner. I hope you enjoyed today's music by the Johnny Smith Quintet, as well as our meeting with Benny Carter and the All-Star Jazz Concert Session. Don't forget to send in your program suggestions. Just write to Jazz Club USA, Voice of America, New York 19. And now this is your host, Leonard Feather, saying goodbye for now and reminding you that the freedom to listen to music includes the freedom to listen to jazz.
Jazz Club USA is a feature presentation of